Hello students, welcome to the new lecture session. Myself Shankho Ghosh, assistant professor of automobile engineering department at Dr. Sudhir Chandra Sur degree engineering college under the GIS. Today we'll continue the lecture on earth moving equipment, which is taken from the module number 1, and this subject is selected from the earth moving equipments and the farm machinery subject, and this is the subject for the third year students of Diploma Automobile Engineering in Automobile Engineering sector. So students, in the previous class we discussed the introduction of the earth moving machinery and the earth moving machines and the farm machines. And after that, for the introduction, we covered the classification and the application of the heavy earth moving machine equipment. So in the previous class, we covered the 10 earth moving equipment. So in between this 14 heavy earth moving machines, we already covered the 10 our 10 types of earth moving equipments, that means from tractor to the grader. Today we will continue this class from the damper. So student, let's start the today's class. Dumper is a vehicle which is designed for the carrying bulk material, often on the building sites. The dumpers are distinguished from the dump truck by the configuration. A dumper is usually an open four-wheel vehicle with the load skip in the front of the driver, while the dump truck has its cab. The truck has its cab in the front of the load to skip, can tip or to dump the load to skip, can tip to dump the load. This is where the name damper comes from. Similarly, they are the normally diesel power . So these vehicles or the heavy earth moving machines or the dump, which is known as the dumper, is used for the loading, transportation and unloading of the loads. Here load carrier, hoist, mechanisms are the important attachments. Coming to the applications, dumper, which is used in construction site for the loading, transport and डंपिंग ऑफ लोड्स फॉर सम डिस्टेंस. सो स्टूडेंट्स हियर द पिक्चर्स आर, सो दिस आर द पिक्चर्स ऑफ ए डंपर. सो दिस इज अ हिप्ड टाइप डंपर एंड दिस इज ए rectangle or straight type down. Now come to the next slide. Next slide is, or next equipment is road roller. All of us are familiar with this road roller. Everyone in between, all of us has seen the road roller on the roadside during the construction of the road. So basically a road roller is a compactor type engineering vehicle which is used to compact the soil, gravel, concrete or the asphalt in the construction of roads and the foundation. Similar rollers are used also at the landfills or in agriculture. The road roller are frequently referred as the steam roller, which is regardless for their propulsion. So this road roller are basically used for compaction of material in road and the construction site. The road roller, the main important attachment is that the road roller at front and the rear, the roller is placed at the front and the rear. The vibrator, scraper, power plant and the transmission control, these are the main important attachments of a road roller, and it is applied, the road roller is applied as a compactor in foundation of roads, airports, dams, etc. And the students, here this is the picture of a road roller. Next is crane. Is crane. Crane is a type of machine which is generally equipped with a hoist rope, wire rope or the chain and the sieves that can be used both to lift and lower the material and to move them horizontally. So it is mainly used for the lifting the heavy things and transporting them to the other places. So students, basically the crane is used to lift, is used for lifting a material and transport the from one place to the another place. So the main functions of the cranes are hoisting, hauling and dumping of loads in the industries, construction projects, mining and the shipyards. Crane boom, load hook guy, and the outer and the outriggers are the main important attachments of this equipment. And the application of this, so before the application, there are the three types of one is directing, another is mobile cable, and the third one is gentry. So here are the three pictures of this. So this one is the directing. These cranes are used for the construction work, industry, and the shipping purpose. This one is the mobile crane. So with the travel mechanism used for the rough reaching work, and this one is the gentry cranes, which is used in the industry sector. So students, up to there complete the 13 types of heavy earth moving machine. So this is the introduction of this earth moving equipment with their some applications, functions, and the important attachment. Later we'll discuss this 13 heavy earth discuss these heavy earth moving machines briefly on later, which is in your model number C. So then coming to the next slide. The next slide is general specification of heavy earth moving machines. So basically plants and the machineries are procured. Plants and machineries are procured by the users to serve some specific purpose in relation to production system. In relation to the production system, a particular part of the machine, a particular part of the machine, when it works efficiently, the efficiency of the machines become directly proportional to its function. But the particular part of that particular machine depends upon other variable of these machines, so that the specification of the machine is necessary to state the specification of the direct and the indirect variable. So students, if we want to buy a device or any machines, like such as an example of a mobile, when we are going or we are decided to buy a mobile, before buy it we want to know the specification and the use requirement of mine. Just because I am using that new mobile which I want to buy. So my requirement of the how can I check my requirement? So I go through the specifications ऑप्शन मोबाइल और द सेल फोन्स दैट स्पेसिफिकेशंस आर कवर्ड माय रिक्वायरमेंट और नॉट. If I am used a mobile as a sales person, so then I need to buy a mobile which has a big battery power, more battery power, so that we cannot, so we as a salesman, he or she cannot connect charge this battery after completing one or up to the few calls. This is a discharge. So he or she need a mobile phone which has a big battery back. So these are the more important this is the more important specification for the salesman. If a businessman want to buy a mobile phone, he is want to see that the phone he or she wants, so in between the phone there is some the writing portion or there or not mailing section, just because he or she have number of email ID for the purpose of the business, and the they are working on it and they have some notepad and recording options. So if he or she buy a phone, so he is go through this specification which is covered. He wants to show the specification which is covered his requirement, his or her requirement. So in that case, the specification is more important to buy a machines or everything. So the plants and the machines are procured, the plants and the machineries are procured by the user to serve the some specific purpose in relation to the production, in relation to the production system. A particular part of a machine, when it works efficiently, the efficiency of the machines becomes directly proportional to its function. But the particular part of that particular machine depends upon the other variable of the machine, so that the specification of the machine is machine. So that the specification of the machine is necessary to state the specification of the direct and the indirect variables. As an example, we take a moving equipment as an example, like bulldozer. So the capacity of bulldozer, so student, the capacity of a bulldozer is depends directly upon the dosing capacity of the blade, which is expressed in the meter cube of soil it can per which is expressed in meter cube of soil and it can does per unit time. So it is important to see or to know the dosing capacity of the blade of a bulldozer, which is expressed in the meter cube per time. So this blade capacity. So this blade capacity of a bulldozer is indirectly varies with the few factors. So the blade capacity is indirectly varied with a few factors. And those are, number one, output of the power plant. Number two, cycle time of the dosing. Number three, mechanism which is used for the mechanism which is used for operation of the blade. Number four, mounting of the machine. And number six, gross weight of the machine. Number five, and the number six, soil condition, and the such other related factors. So students, here a blade, how much soil it is dosing in the scale of meter cube per second, is depends on the these six factors, in this above six factors. So these are the main specifications of the vehicle. So considering these six above six factors, the bulldozers can draw a specification. Depends the specification of the bulldozer are given here. Those are, number one, blade capacity, its size, its type, and the maximum tilt position. So capacity, size, and types of the blade is more important, and beside this, the maximum tilt position of the blade is the most important specification of the bulldozer. Second one is horsepower at the flywheel. And number three, total operating weight. Total operating weight means up to how much weight it can be operate easily. Next is speed range in the various gear positions. Here in various gear position means in the forward direction, in the forward movement, and the reverse movement, how much gear is connected, and the speed range in between during the forward movement and the reverse movement. Next is the turning radius. So if we turn the bulldozer, so what is its turning radius? This is types of the mounting, fuel tank capacities, how much fuel is required, how much fuel is required of a bulldozer. Next is for wheel mounted dozer number and size of the tire, wheel base and ground clearance, etc. So these are the specification of the bulldozer which depends. Now students, coming to the specification of a bulldozer, the famous Caterpillar manufacturing company. Caterpillar is a type of bulldozer. So this type of bulldozer is manufacturing company used to supply and the manufacture the heavy equipment, manufacture the heavy equipment during the post of 1950s in India. So students, during the post 1950s in India, the famous bulldozer maker, bulldozer model Caterpillar make company used to supply and the manufacture the heavy equipment. Now coming to the specifications of this bulldozer. So here is the picture of a bulldozer, and the model number of it D155A, a bulldozer. So this is a D155A bulldozer model. The operating weight is 32,150 kg. So 32,150 kg is the operating weight. The maximum drawbar pull is 65,000 kg. So the 65,000 kg is the maximum drawbar pull. And the model is KT 1150 cc. A horsepower is 320 newton meter at the rate of 2000 rpm. So at 2000 rpm, the horsepower, flywheel horsepower is 320. Next is ground spacer, 0.92 kg per centimeter square. 0.92 kg per centimeter square. Is the ground pressure. Next is transmission. Here the power shifted 3 forward direction and the 3 reverse direction transmission. So here, so in the bulldozer, the gearbox or the transmission system is used for the power which is shifted the 3 forward motion movement and the 3 reverse movement. The number of track shoe, the number of track shoe in each side, the number of track shoe in each side is 41. The capacity of the bulldozer is 10.4 m³, and the speed is 11.8 km in the forward movement, and the 13.7 km in the reverse movement. So these are the specifications of a bulldozer. Next is specification of the dumper. Dumpers are wheel mounted which is having the higher speed than the other type of heavy earth moving equipment. It bears the similarity in specification as in automobile. In India, some of the leading manufacturers of automobile include Tata are also making this vehicle or damper. The Bharat Earth Movers Limited. The Bharat Earth Mover Limited is collaboration with the WAPCO. Is collaboration with the WAPCO Construction and the mining equipment USA. After the collaboration, make a complete setup at Bangalore for manufacturing the dumper from the 25 ton to 170 ton capacities. Now coming to the specification of the damper. Here is a picture of a damper where the engine model is NT855C310. The horsepower is 310 at the rate of 2100 rpm. So at 2100 rpm, the flywheel horsepower is 310. Tire type, it used 6 nose tire at 18.00 to 254 and 24 PR tubeless type. So this is the types of the tire. Now coming to this transmission section. Here manual and automatic power shifted transmission is used. It has 10 forward movement and the 2 reverse movement. It uses hydraulic types of power steering. The dual shoe type brake, which is air over the hydraulic types. And it also used emergency and the parking both type of brake. Hydraulic type post semi electrical leaf spring used as a specific as a suspension. Heavy duty dual shoe is used as a body. Capacity of the dumper is 50 ton. Volume is 12.96 meter cube and the gross vehicle weight is 45,680 kgs. Next is specification of solar. Here this is the model of the diesel Sobel. The bucket capacity of the Sobel is 1.9 meter cube. Engine power is 220 horsepower. Estimated cycle time is 33 seconds. Hoist rope that is 0.4 meter per second. Swing speed is 3.5 rpm. So these are the specification of the Sobel. Next is specification of drag line. Model number is 3W15/90. The bucket type is 15 meter cube. 90 meter boom length is used. 30 degree boom angle is used. 1620 ton is the machine weight. The tube diameter is 14 meter. Average bearing pressure is 1 kg per centimeter square. 2 meter step length is used here and the drag line speed is 60 meters per hour. So these are the pictures of the drag line. Next is specification of a scraper. Struck capacity according to bank measure volume that is 11.50 meter cube and heap capacity according to the loose measure capacity that is 16.06 meter cube. Payload is 213,000 kgs. The engine model is NTA 855 C350 water pool. At 2100 rpm, the flywheel horsepower is 322. The gross weight of this stepper is 49,584 kg. So students, today in this class we covered the rest of the types of earth moving equipments and their application, and then after that we covered the general specification of the typical earth moving machines. So student, from the next class we'll discuss the comparison in between the general automobile and the earth moving machines. So still then, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you so much, students. Thank you.